The Rect Transform is a new component that replaces the usual Transform component on all new UI elements. Whereas the Transform component represented the position, rotation, and scale of a 3D object in the scene volume, the Rect Transform represents a 2D rectangle specified by a width and a height related to a pivot point. Even though the Rect Transform represents a simple 2D rectangle, the component does include a position along the z-axis, as well as rotation and scale, so the element can be manipulated in the scene volume as a 3D object. One important difference between a Rect Transform and the traditional Transform component is the concept of anchors. A Rect Transform can be anchored to its parent if that parent also has a Rect Transform component. Anchoring allows the UI element to move or stretch based on the position and size of the parent UI element's Rect Transform. It is worth noting that all UI elements must ultimately be the child of a canvas, even if they are not immediate children. Canvases themselves have a Rect Transform. So, in almost all circumstances, the parent of a UI element will also have a Rect Transform, and the UI element will be anchored to its parent in some way. For more information on the Canvas component, please see the information linked below. In the scene view, to manipulate a UI element, it is best to use the Rect tool. The Rect tool can be selected by clicking on the Rect tool button in the toolbar, or by using the shortcut key T. With the Rect tool selected, it is possible to move, resize, and rotate any UI element with that one tool. With the UI element selected, it can be moved by clicking anywhere within the rectangle and dragging. The UI element can be resized by clicking on any of the edges or corners and dragging. Note how the cursor changes when hovering over an edge or corner, from the usual pointer to a double arrow aligned with the direction the UI element will resize when dragged. Holding the Shift key will force the UI element to be resized proportionally. The UI element can be rotated by clicking and dragging outside of the rectangle near any of the corners. Note how the cursor changes, indicating when the tool can rotate the UI element. Resizing or rotating a UI element is done in relation to its pivot point. The pivot point is very much like the center point of a standard game object. The pivot point is indicated by a blue ring, which by default starts in the center of the UI element. The pivot point can be moved by clicking and dragging on the pivot point indicator in the scene view. It is worth noting that the pivot point does not need to be inside the rectangle of the UI element. Placing the pivot point outside of the UI element's rectangle can be done for specialized behavior. This, however, is not a common situation. Another difference between the Transform component and the Rect Transform is the effect of global and local space on editing. When editing UI elements in local space, the rectangle and handles are aligned with the UI element. In global space, the rectangles and handles are aligned globally, and the rectangle indicates the bounds of the UI element. This is most notable when the UI element is rotated. In the scene view, anchors are indicated by four small triangles, which by default are grouped together in the center of the UI element's parent Rect Transform. This parent Rect Transform can be the canvas. Anchors will be covered in detail later in this lesson. When looking at the Rect Transform in the inspector, it is clearly different from the Transform component. The position and size of the UI element are shown in the upper right of the inspector for the Rect Transform component. Position shows the distance, in pixels, from the anchor point to the pivot along the X and Y axes. The position Z is the distance along the local Z axis and is often left at a value of 0. Width and height indicate the size of the UI element in pixels. The position and size fields are dynamic and context sensitive. These will be covered in more detail in this lesson as they relate directly to the position of the anchors. The Rect Transform component includes a powerful anchoring mechanism. Rect Transforms can be anchored to their parent if the parent game object also has a Rect Transform component. In most cases, every UI element will be anchored to its parent in some way. In the scene view, the anchors are represented by four small triangle gizmos. Each triangle represents one anchor, and each anchor is associated with one corner of the Rect Transform. The upper left anchor is associated with the upper left corner on the Rect Transform. The lower right anchor to the lower right corner. This is the same for each anchor and each corner. Anchors are positioned within the bounds of the parent's rectangle, not the UI element's rectangle. Anchors cannot be positioned outside of the bounds of the parent's rectangle. Anchors can be moved by clicking and dragging on the triangle gizmo. Clicking in the center of a group of triangles will move the triangles as a group. Clicking on an individual triangle will move one anchor at a time. Anchors have a fixed relationship to their rect transforms, which they are anchoring. Anchors have a flexible relationship to their parent's rect transform, which they are anchoring to. When setting an anchor, the distance between the anchor and the associated corner of the rect transform is a fixed value. The anchor's position within the parent's rect transform, however, is relative to the parent's size and is affected by changes to the size in the parent's rect transform. The anchor's position relative to the parent is a percentage of the parent's size along the x and y axes. And its absolute position can change when the parent's rect transform changes. This percentage is represented by a normalized value from 0 to 1 along each axis, where 0,0 is in the lower left of the parent's rect transform, and 1,1 is in the upper right. Practically, this means if all four anchors are grouped together around a single point, the UI element will be anchored to that point. If the parent rect transform changes in size, the anchor will move relative to this change, and the UI element will move along with the anchor. The UI element will not stretch or resize, as the distance from the anchors to their associated corners is fixed. If, however, the anchors are separated in any way, the UI element will stretch along with a parent, as the anchors and the space between them are relative to the parent's rect transform, and will change in size if the parent changes in size. How much the UI element stretches compared to its parent depends upon the placement of the anchors. A few common cases are positioning the anchors at the corners of the UI element, in which case the stretch will maintain the UI element at the same percentage area of the parent. Positioning the anchors at the bounds of the parent, in which case the space between the edge of the UI element and the bounds of the parent will remain the same, creating a fixed border. Positioning a pair of anchors grouped together at the edges of the parent's rect transform, in which case the UI element will stretch horizontally, but not vertically. The stretching behavior of an anchored UI element can be quickly tested by grabbing the edge of the parent's rect transform and dragging it. Note the preview label that appears when dragging, and note that the parent rect transform snaps back to its original state when the dragging ends. To make editing easier, when positioning anchors by hand, holding the Shift key will change the UI element size as well. How the rect transform is resized depends upon the position of the anchor compared to its associated corner, as the distance between the two is a fixed value. It is important to note a change in the way the rect transform displays the positioning and size information when the anchors are not grouped together and no longer define a single point as an anchor. When all four anchors are grouped together, they define a single anchor point, and the rect transform displays the positional offset from the pivot and the width and height of the UI element. When the anchors are split apart, however, the rect transform displays the fixed values of the left, right, top, and bottom. These are the fixed offsets along the x and y axes of the anchors to their associated corners. If any two anchors are grouped together, there will be no stretching along that axis, and the rect transform will continue to display the position and width or position and height for that axis. When setting the pivot and anchors for a UI element, there are a number of very common configurations. To make setting these quick and easy, the Rect Transform includes the Anchor Presets window. This can be accessed by clicking on the Anchor Presets button. The Anchor Presets button displays the current anchoring choice of the Rect Transform. In the Anchor Presets window, there is a set of common configurations for the anchors and pivot. These common configurations are arranged in a matrix based on the position of the anchors, with fixed anchor points in the middle and stretch options along the outer edge. The anchor position can be set simply by clicking on the desired configuration. Additionally, the pivot, the position of the UI element, or both, can be set at the same time as setting the anchors by holding down the Shift and/or Alt keys when clicking the desired configuration. These optional keys are noted at the top of the Anchor Presets window. Pivot defines the pivot point of the UI element using a normalized value of 0 to 1 along the X and Y axes, with 0,0 in the lower left and 1,1 in the upper right. Rotation defines the rotation of the UI element. In the most common of cases, rotation will only need to be done along the z-axis, keeping the UI element in 2D space. Rotation is allowed on all three axes, however, and the element can be viewed in 3D space. Before discussing scale, it is important to understand the difference between scaling and size. When adjusting a UI element's size in the scene view or adjusting the width and height in the inspector, the UI element is being resized, not scaled. Resizing changes the Rect Transform's width and/or height, but does not scale the UI element. When the UI element is resized, this will not affect the font sizes, the border on sliced images, or other items related to the UI element. When a UI element is scaled, however, the entire element is scaled, including items like fonts and borders. For layout purposes, it is generally recommended to resize a UI element rather than scale it. Scaling, on the other hand, can be useful for animated effects or other special purposes. It is worth noting that a UI element will become invisible if given a negative size. Negative scaling, however, is supported and can be used for effects, including flipping the UI element with a scale of negative 1. The Rect Transform component includes two optional editing modes: Blueprint mode and Raw edit mode. Blueprint mode allows for the editing of Rect Transforms as if they were not rotated or scaled. It is worth noting that the UI element cannot be rotated with the Rect tool when in Blueprint mode. Normally, when editing the pivot or anchor values from within the Rect Transform, the pivot or anchor will move and the UI element will remain in place, just like editing these items in the scene view. When in Raw edit mode, however, the pivot or anchor will stay in place and the UI element will move relative to that fixed item. There are times when a Rect Transform will have some or all of its values driven by a parent Rect Transform or other UI component, such as a layout group. In these cases, some or all of the properties of the Rect Transform will be grayed out and uneditable. When this is the case, there will be a note at the top of the Rect Transform indicating that some values are being driven by another component. For more information on the components driving the Rect Transform, please see the Unity documentation or the associated Learn lesson for that component.